Barry Robertson here from Capital Rock Theatre Company. Tonight is the 6th of June, and we thought we'd film a little bit behind the scenes, because a lot of audience members have been asking about the actors, but we never get time to talk to you after the stage. So I thought we'd do a little bit of a video and just kind of get to know all of our actors. So we've got from left to right, yeah, Natalie.
Hi.
Scott Watson.
Hiya.
And Lindsay
Ashworth,
thank you.
I've got two names.
I keep seeing Malone for some reason, but that's a different actress. That's Kirsty. Yeah.
It's nice to know I've left impression.
No, nah. So I thought we would just kind of talk about Broadway in the Coast, which is just a cabaret night here at the Harbour Arts Centre in Irvine. Lindsay, you've done two of these now. This is going to be your second.
Yes.
And you've done similar shows in cities.
Yeah.
Can you tell us, is there a difference between this show and the ones that you performed in cities?
I think, firstly, I think audiences are really grateful to have this type of thing in their local community rather than having to travel to the cities,
yeah,
like Glasgow or Edinburgh, whatever, to see something like this. So I think that's really valuable. I think, personally, when I was here last time, I was really impressed with how responsive the audience were to everything we did. They love hearing stuff that they know, but they were also really, really receptive to more obscure choices that we made, maybe, which was really nice, actually, because you never know how people are going to react. So I think down here we've been actually really lucky to be able to perform to these audiences, as well as the audiences hopefully appreciating the fact that we're here.
Yeah. Natalie, would you say that's something similar to your experience? Because you do a lot of these in Glasgow, don't you?
Yeah. I mean, I'm excited. This is my first time, obviously, doing it tonight. It was Kirsty Malone that,
yeah,
obviously, could she not do it tonight? Or
she's away in America.
She's away in America, so she'd asked if I'd do it. And I was like, yeah, great, because I've never been here before, so this is my first time going to be performing in Irvine tonight. But I've heard great things from Kirsty, and yeah, I do a lot of cabaret. I think the good thing about it is you've got freedom to just, yeah, try out new things and let the audience kind of get involved. And I like the interaction in small scale,
yeah,
venues.
Yeah.
I think that's quite nice.
And I quite like picking songs that people don't necessarily know.
Yeah.
And I love singing it in front of an audience, and they're actually listening word for word. And they're,
yeah,
they're on that journey with,
yeah,
you, isn't it? It's
absolutely
really nice.
Absolutely, yeah, definitely.
Now, Scott, you're from Troon.
Yeah,
you're an Ayrshire guy, a bit like myself. Now, nothing like this, as far as I'm aware, and probably you can agree, has ever taken place. We're not used to having like a night in musical theatre.
No, definitely not. I'd only say that if it's really these kind of primary schools and secondary schools that will put on musicals,
yeah,
and you've got your kind of drum theatre groups, and people will go and see them in the Gaiety in the Palace, but I don't think there's anything,
yeah,
cabaret style whatsoever.
And nothing with professional actors who have all been in shows, but also bringing something new. I think one of the things is we're completely different vocally and style wise, and the feedback that we've been getting is that it's really nice to hear different styles, but also it's a bit like it's an added value into a local night out with a meal that,
yeah,
people seem to like.
Absolutely,
yeah,
that's great. No, definitely. It gives people something different to,
yeah,
do, you know? And so is it there like a meal deal thing?
Yeah, well,
oh,
there's a meal. The two local restaurants do like a 2-course meal for
£9.50.
So you can buy them separately,
yeah,
and it's closer to home.
Uh-huh.
Whereas if you've,
yeah,
got the train down here, it's what, an hour?
Yeah,
yeah.
Just under an hour?
Yeah.
So, Lindsay.
Yes.
Before we finish up. Why musical theatre?
Well, I remember seeing Cats when I was 12,
okay,
and I'm actually from a little village, so I guess kind of like people down here that maybe don't have the exposure to theatre that people in Glasgow or Edinburgh, Stirling even have, I was exactly the same, but because I lived in a rural community. So when we went to the King's in Glasgow to see Cats, I was just blown away by it. I just was, and also the set for Cats is so crazy and big, and when you're small, or as small as I ever was when I was 12, was amazing, and you get to go up and have your programme signed in the interval, which I thought was personally for me, but I've now found out that they do it wherever you go. So that for me was just amazing, and I think what made me realise that I wanted to do it was that I loved watching them, but I was also jealous because I wanted to be up there. So that was when it kind of started for me, and then, you know, school shows and Amdram stuff while I was at uni and all that kind of stuff just led on to drama school, and it was really just wanting to take what I was doing to the next level. You know, you're working with great people sometimes, but also there's that frustration of going, I think we can be better than this, or I would like to be working at a bit of a higher level. So that's really why I went off and trained.
Yeah, because you've done Blood Brothers and you've done On the Way to a Forum. Do you have a favourite musical?
I think Blood Brothers probably is one of my favourites. I did that at drama school actually, rather than never got to do it professionally. So if anyone's watching, like to employ me to play Mrs. Lyons or Mrs. Johnson, I'm not. I've always been drawn to character roles, I think. So anything where there's, you know, a proper story, which is why I love Blood Brothers.
Good song time.
Yeah, that was interesting because the production I did of Forum was actually an actual musician production, which, you know, was very challenging, having to play all that crazy music as well. I'm sure you guys would agree that a lot of jobs that I've got, I've been extremely excited about, and then they've maybe fallen short of my expectations. Some of my favourite jobs have actually been those which I've either known nothing about the script or the show or whatever in advance. And then you go in and you're just open, you're much more open, you've got no expectations, you just think, I don't know this character already.
It's an acting job, isn't it?
And you actually end up getting far more out of a job like that because you're just there playing, if you like, and seeing what happens. So,
whereas, Scott, you've been a little bit lucky because you've done The Green Door at AirBT, which was completely brand new.
Yeah, totally brand new.
It was a Scottish play. Yeah. How was that experience of, well, it's not Avenue Q, it's not Phantom, I can't really relate to another actor who's played it. What was that like for you, getting this brand new material and having to be the first actor to go through that journey?
Personally, I enjoyed it. It was one of the biggest challenges that I've had. Obviously, getting the music, and I don't play piano myself, but I can read music. But doing that and trying to learn the songs was
going to wait, because
you can't go on YouTube and go, who does the best riff here? Who does the best style of this song? Do you know what I mean? It was really good. But we, like my class and I, we were quite close, that we kind of worked together and did different bits. But the main positive thing of it was there was three guys playing the same part, and we totally played it different, every single person. And I was just lucky in the fact that that character was a kind of a dream character. He wasn't actually in the story and people didn't actually speak to him. So if you played him differently to what everyone else did, then it wasn't an issue, which was amazing to have. But I'm the same. I quite enjoy doing character stuff, but I'd also do the kind of straight down the middle, just man role. But no, I wasn't even meant to be doing musical theatre, which is the funny thing. Because when I was leaving school, I had conditionals to go and do physiotherapy and sports coaching.
You'd regret it now?
Not at all. I decided that I would leave my sports as a hobby and have my musicals as my job, because I didn't want to have it the other way about, just because of how, like, obviously this industry is the same, that jobs aren't secure, but I just kind of had more excitement going up on the stage and getting the audience behind you, do you know what I mean? Like, that's what I love doing, so I was more than happy that after I've finished my 4 years now, that's what I've decided to do. So.
Now, Natalie, you've been down in London for a while, haven't you?
Yeah, I've been back up the road for about three years now. Okay. So I'm running back up.
Are you missing London, considering that's like the centre of British musical theatre?
I mean, I do miss it in some ways, but I think in other ways Scotland is really up and coming in terms of theatre as well, I think. I still go down and up quite a lot, so
Megabus gold.
I'm a drama teacher now. I kind of decided to have a bit of a career change, so I still do a lot of performing on the side, but I've kind of had a wee bit of a career break and I went back and I trained as a drama teacher, so I'm really enjoying that. It's still within, you know, the arts and passing on my skills to the younger generation.
What would you say was your favourite role when you were down in London?
Well, actually, I did the Steamy on tour, but I was understudying Maggot and Doreen, so I wasn't quite sure if I would ever get on, and I did get on for Doreen at the King's, which was a really nice experience. So that wasn't in London, you know, I mean, that was up here, but I don't know, I think, I guess it's just that thing of whatever role you play, you just kind of throw yourself into it, and every role that I've played has been a totally different experience, and a good experience in different
ways. It's weird because when I'm talking to all of us here today, understanding that all of us like character work, we all connect to the music, and I think that's the same for like a small Broadway in the show performance is that there's so many different songs that we're singing, but we're connecting through the thoughts and emotions of those characters and sharing that with an audience. I think it's quite a powerful little intimate performance that you get to share that you don't get the opportunity to do otherwise.
Yeah, definitely.
And it's kind of the opposite of what you might be doing if you're doing a long run of a job.
Yeah.
You know, you get to like month two and you think, oh, I'm starting to get bored now, which is awful because all your friends are like, you're getting paid to dress up and prance about the stage, which is true. But there does have to be something that keeps it fresh every night, and you've got to find that as a performer. And I think this is the complete opposite. You know, we're all panicking, going, oh my gosh, I've got to do four songs and on my own, and I've got duets and company numbers, and I've got to switch from one voice quality to another, or another character between songs and stuff. And I think that is, while it's very scary, it's also really good for us to do that, because it's really easy to get stuck in a rut when you're in a show for a really long time.
And it's what I've noticed about them is it's the vocal technique that you need, because there's so many different ranges of songs and styles and so many different parts of your voice that you need. It's like an absolute marathon sometimes.
Yeah, definitely. And we want to give that to the audience as well. You don't want to just come up and be like, well, I'm the soprano of the group, which I'm not, by the way. But you don't want to do that, because I think everybody was really good with their choices in terms of, you know, trying to give as much variety as possible. So if everybody does that, then you end up with,
Well, thank you very much for taking the time out. We're now about to go away and rehearse again, get all dressed up and glammed up for people arriving tonight. But if you do want to come to a Broadway in the Coast show, the next one's on the 24th of October here at the Harbour Arts Centre in Irvine. So thank you very much, guys. Appreciate it.
Thank you
very much for watching.
We'll see you soon.
See you later.